the modern day slave doesn't know that it's a slave.
The food be thy medicine, medicine be thy food.
The government encouraging people to eat foods that it knew would make them sick because of the lobbying efforts of the industry. And that's really reprehensible.
I grew up in DC eating the standard American diet. I initially identified veganism as a white thing. It was because I didn't know my history. All I knew was we turned scraps into soul food, and I thought that was our only culinary legacy.
It becomes soul specifically assigned to black people because in the 60s, black nationalists wanted to make the argument that black people had culture. We have culture in our language, we have culture in our clothing, we have culture in our food.
Chitlins and chicken wings and oxtail and ox tongue and pig feet. Those were the things that were thrown away that Massa didn't eat. Those were the scraps that were scavenged up by certain slaves.
They made do with what they had, but the fact is that we are no longer on the plantation.
Something a lot of people think about black folks' history in this country, it always like starts with slavery, right? But it really goes back farther than that to the continent of Africa. People were growing food, cultivating the land.
They had crops, they had dirt, and they had seeds. So I can only imagine that most of our diet was always plant-based.
The World Health Organization finally admitted that meat was the leading cause of cancer. Kaiser Permanente is finally endorsing a plant-based diet for optimum health. So eating fresh, healthy crops is a part of our legacy, and it's a part that we should start embracing.
I don't eat no meat. No dairy, no sweets, only ripe vegetables, fresh fruit and whole wheat. I'm from the old school, my household smell like soul food, bruh. Curry falafel, barbecue tofu, no fish.
You have systemic inequality, people who are being beaten down by the detritus of life.
Access to healthy foods in this country has become a privilege instead of a right, which it should be. Cost is a big barrier for probably a lot of people.
The federal government gives subsidies for big food to produce cheap food. So that means that it's going to be cheaper for us to get boxed macaroni and cheese or white bread.
No human is really adapted to eat this way. This diet will cause increased rates of disease and death in us because we are less genetically adapted to eat these foods.
By not drinking that milk, by not eating any animal products, you are not participating in a system that causes harm.
They say you are what you eat.
Vegans are in a position to be able to recognize the suffering of these other beings.
There's no way I'm eating that. There's dead and diseased animals mixed in with the lab ones.
They are not feeding our children. We are feeding our children.
There's the policy side of our health and our wellness, and there's the personal priority side.
As a people, if we want to grow stronger and flourish, we have to be healthy.
A plant-based diet promotes better health, less disease, and greater longevity. You need a clear mind. And to have that, you need a better diet.
Power of psychology. You change your perception.
No meat, no dairy,
if you change your perspective, right vegetables, fresh food, then you see new opportunities.
The moral of the story to hold on to is our genius and our innovativeness. We need more people that look like us pushing that message.
How can one avoid being depressed when it seems in his own eyes millions of people going to bed hungry at night? How can one avoid being depressed when it seems in his own eyes millions of people sleeping on the sidewalks at night?
We need more visibility to a lifestyle that is far too invisible in certain communities. I don't want to be an invisible vegan.